Okay, so in this video I'm going to make an adapter ring to fit this Makita router with a variable speed onto the spindle mount on my CNC machine. I'm going to use quite a long bit, which is actually a foam cutting up spiral bit, but when I was looking at it and comparing it to some of the other bits I have, it seems completely identical in terms of the spacing of the flute. Obviously a longer bit is more likely to break if I put the machine under load. I'm hoping that by using a slower feed rate, I should be able to get through this laminated bit of birch ply. This is two thicknesses of 18 mil, which I actually laminated together when I was making my radial saw. And this was left behind, so I'm going to screw this onto the table and then send the job over and see, hopefully, whether I can get this to cut out nicely. I had a few false starts, first plunging too deeply with a 6mm step down. I then tried to reduce the feed rate with the same plunging depth, but the router still sounded a little jerky. I finally reduced the plunge depth to 3mm with the feed rate set at 1400mm a minute, and that seemed to cut okay. If you'd like to skip the cutting job time-lapse, please press the annotated button on screen now. I had some chipping from the top of the birch ply, and I should really work out a way of making an initial shallow pass over the same vector lines to prevent this in future. The adapter ring didn't fit at first, so I cut open the ring to increase its flexibility and sanded the outer wall using the pillar drill drum sander. I also had to take a little material off the flange so the adapter piece would sit flat. In the next video, I will use this variable speed router to cut the remaining end plates and install them onto the CNC machine. If you have found this video interesting, please make sure you leave a comment, share, or simply thumb this video so the algorithm gods know it's worth recommending over their complicated domain.